morning, good morning. Good morning, good morning. How's it going? Good morning, another day. One more day. What's going on, fellas? Elite Home Buyers Network, what's up, man? Negro Sexto, what's up, Leia? Christian, I got the coffees, bro. I think we're missing the coffee. What's up, Jenny? What's going on, everyone? Time to get it, man. Time to get it. Hey, Jackie, what's up? Chop 67, what's going on? Let's get it. Just shoot for the stars. Gotta get in that mindset. Get in that mindset. Go. If you feel like it, take me away. Make it okay. I swear I'll behave. Yeah, the juice is suck, man. So I was walking up to the coffee place and I was like, I saw two old dudes sitting there, right? I'm just walking by. And it's weird, like, people don't say good morning anymore, man. Like back in the day, or in little towns, like everybody says good morning. And now, for some reason, like you walk by some strangers, people don't even say good morning anymore. I was always amazed growing up how my parents would walk by anyone and everybody would say good morning, even though they didn't even know each other. You know, it felt good. And that's like, nobody says good morning anymore, man. You pass by some strangers, just walk by, like they're not even, like they don't even exist. You gotta make them offers, man, they'll come back. I'm buying that 5-acre property for 80,000 bucks, 82 now. They originally had at 170. It's worth around 200. Would that have happened if I didn't send that offer? I sent that offer like 2 months ago. Eventually they'll come back. They'll send you a text. They save your number. Lowball fuck guy. Like they'll save your number. And when they need a fucking lowball, they'll come to you. Lowballing motherfucker. Boom. I'm sure you're saved. If you're not saved in somebody's phone number right now under some sort of derogatory name, then you haven't made enough low balls in your life. I want to be saved. What's up, Claudio? I want to be saved on every realtor's phone number under lowballing motherfucker. So that whenever they have something they need a lowball on, they'll call me. Oh shit, this guy's honking. The guy's honking next to me. He sounds like he has $30 in his bank account. He's fucking angry. God damn. You guys see that shit? Oh my god. Anyways. Those are the things that we can't control, man. We can't control people's anger. We can't control their life. You know, like we can't control what people are feeling. We can't control how they act against us. But we can control how we feel, how we act with the other people around us. That guy's like cutting everyone right now, trying to get away from me. He probably feels like shit. But that's the thing, man. We can control our attitude. We control how nice we are to people. We can make somebody's fucking day by commenting on some bullshit that they post. Somebody posts a fucking stupid picture of a fucking cat laying down and shit, and you comment, oh my god, that is so fucking adorable. You just made somebody's fucking day right there, man. You make them feel like, yes, god damn it, I got a comment. A simple comment can change somebody's fucking day in a second. Isn't that crazy? We don't even fucking do it. We don't comment on shit. Now it's hard for us to fucking click like on anything. When a simple like, a simple comment, a simple good morning can change somebody's day, man. I think we have to get back to that, man. We have to get back to the days of having manners, to the days of being polite, to the days of being human. It's like the world's turning into a bunch of grouches, man. How many leads? Right now, I mean, we're at a steady 250, 270, 300 on the daily, man. On the daily, like our CRM is always, we bring it down to like 250, then it gets back up to like 270, 280, 290. So it's always at like at a steady amount. But that's how we got that deal last week. That's all that spread. So just gotta hang on, man. Gotta hang on. You have to have a lot of income streams, a lot of little businesses, a lot of little hustles. You know, when we went 100% with this real estate stuff, all real estate, we had a shitload of hustles, man. We played in the band. I sold fucking dogs. I sold fucking aluminum and shit. You haven't been broke unless you've fucking picked up cans and aluminum and shit and sold that motherfucker for $80 to $100. That's how you know you've been poor, man. When you go and look through your parents' shit for aluminum, man, to sell that shit for $100, that's how you know you've been broke. Don't get me wrong, though. You don't have to be broke to have motivation. What's up, Lara? You just have to be hungry, man. You need to prove something, man. If you were born in a good position financially, guess what? You have a huge responsibility on your back to set your own path, to do your own shit, to show that you can make it. But guess what? Since there's already money involved, it's hard as fuck. Because, you know, they already set the bar, man. They set the bar high as fuck. When there's no money in your family ever, there's no fucking bar. That is the bar. Nothing. Nothing is the bar. So therefore, it could be a little bit easier, man, to make a bag, to set a name. But I'll tell you what, man, it's easier to make money with money than with no money. Yeah, it's satisfying as fuck, man, to be the first one to get to a level. Dude, like, let me tell you guys something, man. Last night, I get a call from my aunt in Mexico, man. My cousin, she's giving birth and shit, and she needs an emergency C-section, all right? So let me tell you guys why you guys need to be financially set. This is what she told me, man, her exact words last night. Hey, we're over here at the hospital. She needs an emergency C-section. These motherfuckers don't take credit over here in Mexico. They want cash. And she's like, and I was asking God, what do I do, God? We got no fucking money. And she's like, and guess what God told me? God told me to call Ramon. That's what she said to me, man, my aunt in Mexico. You know? And God was right. Took me 10 fucking seconds after I heard what was going on. Send her money for that shit. Alright. So if you're not financially set enough to where you can help people with things like that, emergencies and shit, I don't even ask anymore, man. I don't ask for my money back. I don't ask for shit. I just do it. You have an emergency, you're at the hospital. Guess what? She sent me a video. She sent me a video of the baby being born, man. Here, let me show you guys what I'm... Alright, I'm gonna put a video of the baby being born. Hopefully I can turn it off. I don't know how to turn that motherfucker off. God damn it. Here, hold on. Let me show you guys, man. I have no fucking clue how to put anything. God damn it. Here, this one, maybe. Here you go. Are you guys seeing this shit? Don't get grossed out. I haven't seen it myself, but it's a fucking baby being born. That's what my aunt sent me. A picture of the baby that I pretty much paid for. You ever paid for a baby before? Baby being born, man. My cousin's probably gonna be all embarrassed. Why the fuck you posting my shit on social media? God damn it. Look at that. That's a baby being born, man. That's what they called me for last night. You know how good it feels, man, to be involved in this? Like, it feels really good, man. I was involved in this last night, man. My aunt calls me and is like, hey, she needs an emergency C-section. We can't fucking pay it. They won't fucking do it. This is Mexico. They want cash up in here. I was like, don't even sweat it. I got you. And she sends me that video. She's like, look, man. I don't even know how to fucking get rid of these videos in the background. I have no fucking clue. So I'm just gonna stay there and playing in the background. So I'm telling you guys, man, you guys need to be ready. You guys need to be financially prepared to do things like this, man, to help people out. Because you guess what, man? What your aunt says, God told me to call you. Guess what? Well, God was right. I am the guy to call for shit like this. You know? That's why we gotta be ready, man. We gotta be ready. We gotta become that person that does these things for people, man. To help people out. Help your family out. Nobody else is gonna help them out. Who else is gonna help them out? They call anybody else, everyone's a fucking piece of shit. And even if they're not a piece of shit, most people don't even got any fucking money to support their own goddamn selves. So you have two options, man. Either in life, you're a piece of shit, you don't care, you don't have any fucking money, not your fault. How the fuck are you gonna help? You don't got fucking money. Or either you become the person that is not a piece of shit and that has fucking money to help people out and things like this, man. So that's what I'm telling you guys, man. You guys gotta have a bigger why in mind. My why is to help people out in emergencies. Alright? My uncle died like 4 months ago. And my mom's like, hey man, do you have any money so we're all raising money so we can bury your uncle? My grandma's crying. My aunt's uncles are crying. And I'm like, dude, don't even worry about it. I'll pay for the whole damn thing, man. Don't worry about car washes. Don't worry about none of this shit. Just tell me how much it is. I got it. You know, that's what I'm telling you guys, man. You guys need to become that person that is able to do these things, man. You don't want your mom crying and shit and then trying to, you know, ask people for money to bury her brother, man. You gotta be the guy that shows up and says, hey, I got this, man. Y'all don't even worry about it. Light work. And guess what? Sooner or later, God, the universe, sees how you are and they bless the fuck out of you with $100,000 fucking deals. Alright? Don't get me wrong, we have to be prepared as fuck for when these blessings come up, because if you're not prepared, you're not going to be able to take advantage of these blessings. You're going to fucking make $5,000 on a deal versus $100,000 on a deal by not being prepared. How do we get prepared? We paid a lot of fucking money to get prepared, man. The first thing we did after we made money is throw it all away in fucking education. $50,000, 1 month. Until we were throwing up education, man. But guess what? This month we already landed a couple $100,000 deals. Last month we ended up with a couple $100,000. Every fucking month since then we've ended up over $150,000 per month. So guess what? It was worth it. And now when one of my relatives calls me with an emergency, hey, your cousin's giving birth, we can't afford to pay for the C-section, man. Can you help me out? Can you imagine, like, my aunt, she was in the hospital. She was fucking sitting there praying, asking God, how the fuck am I going to pay for this shit? And all of a sudden in her head, she says God told her, call Ramon. Isn't that crazy? That is some crazy stuff, man. But guess what? It took me 5 seconds. After I heard what was going on, boom, go. Fucking run to the store. I got you. It'll be there in 2 minutes. Now, I'm not sharing this with you guys to brag, because there's nothing to brag here. What am I bragging about? Helping people? I'm sharing this to show you guys what you guys can do. At the end of the day, you guys could choose to do whatever you guys want with your money. You know, you could help people. You could not help people. You could buy yourself shit. You could not buy shit. I'm just showing you guys what I have chosen to do with my shit. I've chosen to do shit like this. There's only one. There's only one of the things that I'm doing to help my people out, man. One thing. My parents went to my grandma's house. They don't have a fucking kitchen. They don't have a fucking floor. They don't have a fucking roof. I told my parents, hey, tell my grandma I got this. Let her know I got this. I'm going to redo her whole fucking house. They don't have AC. Okay, I got this. You know? It just depends, man. It depends who you want to become. You know, some people might be like, you're a fucking liar, man. You haven't helped me. Well, guess what? I've helped pretty much every single person that has... anybody that's asked me for help, I have helped, man. Some people I've helped like over 20 times. If I've helped your ass over 20 times, get what? Your ass is cut off, man. I can't help you. If I help you once or twice and your ass keeps coming back for help, then you don't need my help. My help didn't do you no fucking good. You need help from someone else, because obviously my help didn't fucking work. It's like anything, man. You gotta help someone out. They keep coming back for more help. Guess what? You're not their person to help them. You didn't do shit for them. Unfortunately, I tried to help you. My help wasn't good. You owe ass needs to find higher level help. Because my help is not helping you. Sometimes we think we help people by giving them money. We don't. You don't help them out. You got to realize that, man. Guess what? You got to save those blessings for other people. Other people have needs too. You know, do you think this is important? Somebody giving birth and shit can't afford it. Things like that, man. Just because I'm not helping one person anymore doesn't mean I'm not helping other people. I flew 3 family members to Cancun with us last month or this month. I flew my parents to Cancun. I put them all up in beachfront fucking rooms. Hooked everything up 100%. And it's not the first time, man. I've been doing this since the first time we got a little bit of money, man. So those are the things, man. Those are the things that people don't see. But I'm telling you guys, man, this is why you guys have to fucking make it. And some of you guys might be wondering, okay, well, how the fuck do I make it? I'm about to tell you. You're in luck. You came to the right place. I'm not going to tell you to go skip trace people using my skip tracing. Although, if you do, great. You're going to get an invite to the networking event. GreatSkips.com. I'm not going to ask you to go get lists. I'm not going to ask you to go get cold callers. I'm not going to tell you to do some Excel shit. Because you guys probably already heard all that. All right, what I am going to tell you is this. Go find a deal from somebody else that already has a deal. I can't stress this enough. Like, I just said this a couple of times this week. We're already about to close a deal in Vegas with one of our homies that just got a deal from somebody else that nobody knew about. We're about to make $15,000 with this dude. Like, no fluff, man. I'll bring him on and I'm going to tell him. In Vegas, all right? Atlanta, same thing. We're closing a deal with another dude in Atlanta. He didn't get the deal. He found somebody that had the deal. Brought it to us. We sold it to our hedge fund buyer. He's getting paid. So you don't have to do all the steps to get money. My favorite reward I've ever gotten myself. Man, this is gonna sound horrible. Here you go. Y'all see this? This is what this is probably like the only thing I've ever bought for myself. Like vanity wise, like dumb shit. Because you guys have to buy some dumb shit, all right? Don't feel like you make a little money, you need to save it all. You need to buy some dumb fucking shit. And you need to feel horrible afterwards. Because you're like, God damn it, I spent $5,000 on a fucking watch that I don't fucking need. Any fucking watch tells the time. But guess what, man? You guys have to do it. You guys have to buy some dumb shit. This is the dumbest shit I've ever bought. That made me the happiest. Check this shit out. This is a... It's not the fanciest of the watches, man. It's a Tag Heuer Carrera. But it needs to have a reason behind it. I can't just go buy a dumb fucking shit for no reason, man. It needs to have a meaning behind it. For those that know me, what's the meaning behind this watch? When I used to work for a company, my boss used to have this watch. And that watch signified superiority. It signified his power over me. It signifies that he was the man. It signifies that he was better than me. It signified that he made more money than me. It signified that he was in a higher position than me, all right? So one day I said to myself, one day I'm gonna fucking make $100,000. I'm gonna make $200,000. And it's not gonna hurt for me to go buy a $5,000 watch. And then I'm gonna be the fucking boss. I'm gonna have the boss watch. And every time I wear this fucking watch, it's gonna remind me that I became the fucking boss after all that shit that went down. You know? That's what this watch means to me. I didn't buy this watch. I could have bought a Rolex. Don't get me wrong. I could have bought a 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 50 fucking $1,000 watch if I wanted. I didn't buy it because I'm not like that. I'm not a guy. I'm not a material guy. You guys will never see me with fucking chains and like rings and shit. That's not what I'm about. But guess what? This watch signified... I've had the screenshot of this watch on my fucking phone for the past 3 years, man. You know what it's like to look at your phone screen? I'm sure you guys do. And just see a picture of a watch that you can't afford. I've had that screenshot on my fucking phone for 3 years. I had the screenshot saved in my photos. And I was like, one day, man. One day I'm going to get there. One day I'm going to fucking buy it. And the thing is, like, I could have bought it like a long time ago, but I couldn't afford it. Like, just because you have money to buy it doesn't mean you can afford it. So I was like, damn it, man, I made $15,000. I need to buy that watch. But guess what? I can't afford it. If $15,000 is all the money I got, that doesn't mean I can afford the fucking watch. I didn't want to buy the watch until I knew that I could fucking afford it. All right, so I was waiting, waiting, waiting. Eventually, time came. I was in Vegas celebrating, living it up. Shit, we got here, man. Them bills are in the bank. Rodrigo, let's fuck some shit up today. The day came, man. I was in Vegas. Let's fuck some shit up. I'm here. I'm celebrating. I have my parents. I flew them over. And guess where we going? We going to the goddamn watch store. Boom. Done. My brother was kind of relieved. He was like, finally, man, you've been fucking... bullshitting about that watch forever. I'm so fucking tired of that watch conversation. That's it, man. So if you guys want to make money today, like right now, no bullshitting, find us a house anywhere. Vegas, Atlanta, Arizona. 1980 or newer, 3-2. 1980 or newer, 3-2, Atlanta, Vegas, Arizona. If you do that, you're gonna get paid, all right? You don't have to find this deal yourself. You don't have to text anyone. You don't have to skip trace anyone. Go to other people's lists. Network with other wholesalers that are getting deals. Tell them, see, I don't know how to turn that fucking video off. It's been on playing for a while. Tell them, hey, man, I'm your guy. I have a buyer. If you get anything 3-2s, 1980 or newer, I'm your guy. Just say that. Honestly, these guys are buying anything like it. In the 200 to 300 range. So if you have anything good like that, hit me up. You're gonna get paid. Like I said, don't worry about skipping. Don't worry about spending money. All you have to do is go on your phone, look for wholesalers and tell them, hey man, you got any 3-2s, 1980 or newer, I'm your guy. I have a guy picking it up quick. That's all you have to do. Some people are doing it. Some people are gonna do it. Some people won't do it. Some people are just sitting there like, oh, what the fuck's that in the background? That's it. All right, y'all, we're going to get to it. Yesterday, we had a good day. Check this. Oh, shit, the new whiteboard showed up. We're going to get the new whiteboard. We got a new whiteboard. When you run out of space on a whiteboard, that means shit's going good, man. Well, you need another fucking whiteboard because the one you got is already full as a motherfucker. You know shit's getting good. If you have a whiteboard and there's fucking nothing on it, guess what? Put some shit on it, man. We just got our other whiteboard. This is the one I recommend. It's one of those sticker whiteboards. I got it on Amazon. It's by Post-it. Dry erase surface. We're gonna put it right here. Finish it out. Whiteboard's gonna go right there. We filled this one up. That one is full. So Christian's goal is 10,000. He did 10,000 already. He sold another one yesterday. So he's already passed his goal. These other two fools are at zero still, but they've been training and shit, so it's all right. Totally, the monthly goal is 150. We are short 72,000. We're current 10 for the week, which our weekly goes 50. So we're short 40. Total for the month, we're at 78,000 in revenue. Connecting, here we go. All right, so. So that's what it looks like, man. No fluff. I ain't gonna sit here and tell you we're doing fucking miracles when we're not. That's our goal. That's how much we're short. That's where we're at right now. Do I think we can hit 100,000? Fuck yeah, we can. So even if we don't hit 150, we'll fucking hit 100,000 all day. So, hey, I'll take it. Whiteboard goes on this wall. We'll show you guys later. We do deals in Atlanta. We do deals in Arizona, Phoenix area. In Atlanta, we like Decatur, Lilburn, Lawrenceville. In Vegas, we're doing deals in Vegas. Anything like around 200 is a deal. Honestly, like, yeah, you can do it. You can talk to the owners and this and that. But people that can't do it, that can't afford to do it, like, just go to other wholesalers, man. There must be 1,000 wholesalers in Atlanta that have 1,000 fucking deals in their list that we don't know about. There must be 1,000 wholesalers in Vegas that have 1,000 fucking deals on their list that we don't know about. All right, we know very little about Atlanta, very little in Vegas, but we're doing deals, man. We're doing deals there. We have a very hot buyer. 3-2s, 1980 newer. Just get on those lists. Just find the wholesalers, get on their list, send us their shit. We'll fucking sell it. You get paid. Do that until you figure out how to do it on your own. Once you figure out how to do it on your own and shit starts working, guess what? Now you can do two things. You could still get those from the wholesalers and still do your own. So you can do a little bit of everything. All right, man, we're gonna get to it. Rodrigo's about to set that whiteboard. Also, one thing that I recommend, have things that motivate you, have things with high energy around you. Like this thing was a gift from my homie Art. I love this thing, man. I love like the energy that it has. It was given to me for my birthday. So I have that right there. A couple of dies for the crafts table. Reminds me of Vegas, good times. Got some real, real Bellagio poker chips that I just brought back with me. Energy, like how much energy is this $100 chip got, you know? How much energy is this $25 chip got? I have some cards over here. Energy, man, like, ooh, shit. Where my ace is at? We have a fucking guitars and shit. It's all about energy, man. Our podium should be working. I don't know, maybe like links of it aren't working. But yeah, Podio should be working, man. Let me know, man. As long as they're 3-2s, they have a little bit of spread, 1980 or newer, that's it, man. My goal? This is my goal, man. You have to have a vision, all right? This is my vision. My vision is to go through a huge-ass networking event in Atlanta. I know so many cool dudes in Atlanta. So many cool people in Atlanta. Like, that's my goal, to go and throw a huge, huge event in Atlanta. Second huge event in Vegas. and link that shit up. Link Vegas, Atlanta, and Arizona up. So you guys can send me a DM. We can do it here. I can send you guys my number. But honestly, like, DM probably works best. Email offers@wyhouses.com. Offers@wyhouses.com. You can always DM me too, but probably the email is the best. We'll see it there. It goes straight to the dispo guys, so they're on it very quickly. Here's the whiteboard, man. If you guys have the normal human whiteboards that you have to lift, I would not recommend it. We've been there. We hate those. This is just a sticker. It's a giant sticker, like that one on the wall. So we're going to put this giant sticker right there, and now we're going to fill it up with numbers and shit. All right. All right, man. We out. Hopefully you guys got some value out of this. Look at that video in the corner, man. I paid for that birth, goddammit. Isn't that a good feeling? Should. The Lord sent me to them. That's what they said. Hey, the Lord said your name. What am I going to say? No to the Lord? All right. Peace.